Welcome to Ship Creek, Alaska, Anchorage's urban salmon fishery. Some people might call the fishing here combat fishing. I prefer to think of it as community fishing. Every time I've come down, I've just had a great time with the people around me. Everybody's there just to have a good time. When fishing Ship Creek for salmon, the most important thing to remember is the tide. There's two types of fishermen. The type that fish the incoming and outgoing tide, and then those that fish the low tide. They target salmon that have holed up in the stream once the tide's gone out. I'm a high tide fisherman, so I won't be going into flipping, but I'm sure there's plenty of YouTube videos out there how to accomplish that. The first key to success on Ship Creek is to get there early. Not every spot on the river is the same. There's definitely some spots that are better than others, and it's first come, first serve, so if you want a good spot, you've got to get there early. If you're not from Anchorage, it's important to remember that during high tide, Ship Creek goes from a stream to almost 20 feet deep. This definitely influences where the fish will be found, as well as where you can fish from. The fish will ride an incoming tide into the stream. It's important that you watch downstream. As you see fish being caught, you know that a pod's moving up through the stream, and you need to get ready. Another key to success on Ship Creek is having a good net. Sometimes the bigger the better. Almost as important as a good net, maybe even more important, is a good netter. Remember, when you're netting a king, you want to net them head first so that they swim into the net and not away from it. Another common method is to drag them up onto shore. Sometimes if you have an inexperienced netter, a combination of both will work.
Nicely done.
There's far more fishermen than kings, so hooking one's going to take some patience. Just remember, hooking one's not the same as landing one. If you don't happen to catch king on the incoming tide, don't give up hope. A good number of the fish will head out with the outgoing tide, so you can ambush them on the way out. And remember, it is a community fishery, so people will likely lend you a net and feel your pain when you lose a fish. There's usually a strict limit on kings, so some people will release the smaller ones, hoping for a bigger one. While you're here, don't forget to sign up for the derby. If you don't, you're likely to get a big fish and not be able to cash in on it. This gentleman does a pretty good job of the shore landing technique. I'd say only about 20% of the kings I see hooked are actually caught. Most of them are lost pretty close to the net. One thing I would advise never to do is to grab the line. Grabbing the line makes it much more likely that it'll break. As the tide gets higher, you can see the fishing spots get pretty sparse. You also don't want to get stuck in the mud on an incoming tide. A lot of people think you have to cast clear out into the middle, but a lot of the success I saw came from closer to shore. I'm cheating a little bit. This hookup came after about 3 days of fishing, but finally it was my turn. Hope I have a good netter.
coming in, coming in. There we are. Yeah. Alrighty. Thanks, man. Appreciate the net.
This king weighed in at just over 16 pounds. If I'd had a derby ticket, I probably would have won something.
That's a little bigger than you felt at first.
A couple of other things that you're going to want include a fillet knife. You're going to want to bleed it as soon as you get it on shore, as well as fillet it out. A fish club. Nothing's more heartbreaking than seeing a fish slide back into the water after you've landed it on shore. Probably some plastic bags to take your fillets wouldn't hurt as well. Here's the setup I use. I start with two 5-aught Gamagatsu hooks with egg loops. I use roe in an egg sack. That just makes the roe last longer. Probably it's better to change your roe out more often, but I didn't have a lot of roe. Then In front of that, I have a couple beads, then a spin and glow, about 18 to 24 inches of 30-pound test, and then a swivel. Behind that swivel, I have a slider with a 2 to 4-ounce weight attached to it. Then you just cast it out to your place of choice. The spin and glow will spin just off the bottom. If you put it in the right place and a king comes along, there's a good chance he'll grab it and try and crush the eggs. They're not really trying to eat them, so they won't hold on to them for a long time, so you want to set the hook. That's how I catch my fish. There's probably better ways, but it's worked okay for me. And of course, don't forget a camera. If you'd like to see an Alaska salmon fishing experience that's the complete opposite of Ship Creek, click on the link at the top of the video.
All right, so we're just gonna kinda cut across here.